do you think's the perfect shade that goes with my mask?
Hi, I'm Mishti Max, and I'm here to share this lip art tutorial inspired by a neon sign shaped like a set of lips. Neon signs are sexy, sleazy, and real pretty to look at. And since I was in a youthy blacklight mood, I whipped out these badass disembodied glowing wireframe lips. I'm sliding on a prophylactic layer of MAC Prep and Prime Lip Base to get into the mood. Second base is the Australis Lip Liner in Romance, and I'm running that around the edge of my lips to map out my regular angular shape. This is just for a guide, because I don't have a lip liner that matches this lipstick, the Lime Crime Metallic Velveteen Liquid Lipstick in Blondie. It looks kinda grody, because it's been dried out since I bought it, but it works perfectly fine, so I laid down the light pink shimmery base. I unzipped and whipped out the Glorious and Tumescent Stargazer Fluorescent Pressed Powder in Rouge. And with the aid of the tiny Sigma E36 blending brush, I fluffed it around the edge of my lips. It's not the size that counts, but the motion of the ocean, as they say. And this itty-bitty brush really gets the job done. I'm placing the center of my brush right over the edge of the lip line, so I have a perfect halo of neon orangey red all around the form of the lips. I will tell you a little secret. If you blend eyeshadow around your lips with a fluffy blending brush and happen to be breathing at the time, you will get eyeshadow up your nose. I'm seriously, you guys. You can't really see it under normal light conditions, but when you check your glow levels in the dark, you will clearly see your nostrils and nose hairs coated and shining brightly. It was really hilarious. I'm also focusing the juicy hot pigment through the center between the lips. I have to practically deep throat that damn brush to make sure I can get the neon powder in that inner rim so it shines hard and lights up my fucking teeth, which you'll see by the time I'm at the climax of the tutorial. Anyway, I'm even going in with a finger to get solid payoff inside there. Next, I'm unveiling the remarkable and potent Kryolan UV Aqua Color Paint in UV Red. And fuck that, I always forget that it likes to escape the bondage of the pan. I mixed up a creamy paint by activating the watercolor with MAC Fix Plus Spray. And when I have a nice thick working consistency, I delicately traced a line over the perimeter of the lips. I'm using a skinny eyeliner brush to keep firm control over the width of the stroke and balancing my hand against my chin while going really slowly and carefully to keep the line centered in the neon haze. You can have fun staring down my gullet as I attempt this awkward position and have a time of it practically painting the inside of my mouth. I will say that the paint has a slightly sweet flavor and is not all that unpleasant to consume, but I'm not entirely sure about the nutritional benefits of this art medium. After letting loose and going wild for a minute, I realized that adding the mega bright paint really throws off the saturation of the eyeshadow pigment I laid down underneath it. So I went back in for another triple X throwdown and tickled that tiny fluffy dude all across the contours of the lips, really packing on the shadow to reach maximum pigmentation. Lastly, I took a dry cotton bud to clean up the center a bit and keep the rest of the lips free from surplus luminescence. And now I'm left satisfied and positively glowing because I have the pleasure of insane phosphorescent rimmed lips. As usual, it was so fun to play with the blacklight, and this effect works so fucking well because it totally ended up how I envisioned it. The awesomely strong Kryolan UV paint brilliantly blasts through the darkness, illuminating like the stimulating gas-filled light source should, and the sassy haze of matching pigment provides the subsequent incandescence that the neon sign would cast. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this fluorescent lip art tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Also, check out my band and podcast on iTunes. And my PO box is in the description box.